Hello everyone! Hello grade 8 students! It's me again, Ma'am Tere Buena, your guidance counselor, and we are now going to start with module 2 of your homeroom guidance. And the title of module 2 is I Can Be Better. So I hope you are now ready, so please get a copy of this module and the paper and the pen so we can now start with our discussion. Okay, so as you can see in this module, okay, so we have here the same with module 1. We have here a message for your parents. So please let your parents read this part. So again, I would like to remind everybody that we have to ask for the guidance of our parents while answering this module. So it's very important na nandyan din ang mga magulang natin para gabayan tayo sa pagsagot ng ating mga homeroom guidance module. So therefore, we need their cooperation in order for us to answer this module properly. Okay, so let's try to have this gabay sa magulang or tagapag-alaga. Isinulat ang module na ito upang gabayan ang mag-aaral na linangin ang kanilang aspektong personal at sosyal, akademiko at karera. Dinisenyo ito para sa distance learning o alternatibong pamamaraan ng pagkatuto na hindi nangangailangan ng physical na presensya sa paaralan bilang tugon sa direktiba ng pagkansela ng face-to-face class dulot ng pandemyang COVID-19. Maaring may mga pagkakataon na hingin ng inyong mag-aaral, inyong patnubay sa pagsunod sa mga tagubilin at pagsagot sa mga tanong sa bawat bahagi ng mga gawain. Hinihiling ng DepEd ang inyong suporta upang matagumpay niyang may sakatuparan ng mga gawain ito. Makakatulong ang araling ito upang hubugin ang kanyang kabutihan na tanggapin ang pagkakaiba iba-iba ng bawat tao sa katangian, kakayahan, damdamin at pananaw. Tiyakin na sasagutin niya ang bawat bahagi ng module ng tapat at siguraduhing maipapasa niya ang kanyang sagutang papel sa petsa at oras na itinakda ng kanyang gurong tagapayo. Okay, so again, please let your parents read this part. Okay, so now, for you, my dear learners, we have here the introductory message. Okay, so this module is designed to help you in academic-related needs, concerns affecting your individuality or self, relationship with others, and interaction in the community, and interests, talents, and skills discovery, which will help you to explore future career options and opportunities. So again, like module 1, we have here 6 interactive activities for you to follow. Namely, we have the let's try this, which will help you to get ready to learn. Let's explore this, which will guide you towards what you need to learn. Keep in mind, which will give you the lessons that you need to learn and understand. You can do it, which will help you apply the lessons learned in daily activities. What I have learned, which will test and evaluate your learning. Share your thoughts and feelings, which will help you express your thoughts, opinions, and feelings. And again, make sure to read, think, follow, and enjoy every task that you are asked to do. And have fun, stay safe, and healthy. Okay. So again, the title of module 2 is I Can Be Better. So for the learning objectives, we have the following. At the end of the module, at the end of this module, you are expected to, number 1, identify the different ways and how to help the family and community. Number 2, demonstrate self-control as a responsible member of the family and the community in the current situation. Number 3, assess the different changes as an adolescent in terms of abilities and potentials. Number 4, determine the areas or situations where the similarities and differences could be a great help. And number 5, appreciate the role of the familial duties in building relationships with family members. So this module is good for week 2 to week 4 of this school year. So suggested total time allotment 180 minutes, and you will be needing the following materials: paper and a ballpen. Okay, so let's have now the introduction. Okay, so are you still with me, grade 8 students? Okay, so let's begin. For the introduction, as you grow old, you realize that your abilities and potentials become more refined compared to those in the previous years. Yes, this is correct, okay? Our abilities and potentials become more refined compared to our previous years. So expectations are also adding up, and you might be more focused on how to do things your way, but now you may be starting to see how you affect your family and community. You need to account now how your self-control matters to your family and community. Moreover, you get to appreciate your similarities and differences with others and its roles in dealing with the current situations. Can you imagine if all of us are thinking or living the same way? So parang hindi ko ma-imagine na pare-pareho ang klase ng pamumuhay natin, hindi po ba? How would that affect your duties in the family and your relationship with family members? So again, this module offers an opportunity for you to go through the things mentioned earlier and hopefully get to upgrade your understanding of yourself and others. Ayan. So for our first activity, again, you are expected to write this on a sheet of paper. So it can be a bond paper or a pad paper. It's up to you. Okay. So suggested time allotment is 30 minutes and the title of this activity is Vital Me. Okay. When we say vital, ano bang ibig sabihin ng vital? Vital means important, essential, or importante, or mahalaga. Okay? So, vital me. So, let's try to have the instruction. So, it is said here that what you're going to do is you're just going to recall situations from your younger years. Ayan, magre-reminis tayo. Aalalahanin natin yung ating mga experiences when we were still young, and that experience is when you were already starting or you have already started helping your family and community. Again, let's have the instruction. Recall situation from your younger years where you started helping your family and community. List down the help you have been rendering since that age and copy the table below on a sheet of paper and write your answer. So you can see there are two columns. The first column is, you can see there the age from starting from 1 year old up to present. And the second column, you can see there the help rendered in the family and community. Ano ba yung mga naitulong mo sa iyong pamilya at komunidad na mga panahong ikaw ay yung una, 1 year, 1 year old, so 4 years old? Ano kaya yung naitulong mo na nung ikaw ay isang taong gulang pa lamang hanggang 4 na taon? So, this can be just very simple task or things na pwede mong naitulong, so you can write it down in the column. So, we have there some examples like watering the plants, washing the dishes, running errands, throwing garbage properly, working on community project, volunteering in tree planting activities. So those are some of the examples that pwedeng naitulong mo sa yung community or sa yung family. When you were still 5 or 8 years old, ano naman kaya yon? During 9 to 12 years old, ano naman kaya? And 13 years old up to present, ano kaya yung mga naitulong mo naman sa iyong community and even sa iyong family? Okay, now after accomplishing the table, you are now going to answer the processing question. So the processing questions are, so again, you're going to write your answers on a sheet of paper. Number one, what do you notice on the things that you have done and currently doing in your family and community? Ano ba yung napansin mo sa mga bagay na nagawa mo at presently or currently na ginagawa mo para sa iyong pamilya at komunidad? And can you cite the similarities and differences? Ano ba yung pagkakaiba at pagkakahalintulad ng mga nailagay mong mga bagay na naitulong mo nga sa iyong community and to your family? Okay, that's question number one. And for number two, What makes such similarities or differences? Ano kaya sa tingin mo ang dahilan bakit nagkaroon ng mga pagbabago? Nagkaroon ng pagkakahalintulad at pagkakaiba ang mga sagot mo simula nung ikaw ay bata pa hanggang ngayon na ikaw ay nasa present na age mo na. Okay. So, ano ba yung pagkakaiba ng mga naitulong mo nung ikaw ay 1 year old pa lang up to present? Okay. So, that's what you're going to put there in the processing question. Okay? So, next, after that part, okay, so under let's explore this, the suggested time allotment is 30 minutes. So, again, meron na naman tayong table na isusulat sa ating papel. Okay? On a scale of 1 to 5, with 5 as the highest and 1 as the lowest, how do you rate your self-discipline and the discipline of the members of your family? Okay, i-rate natin. From the scale of 1 to 5, ano kaya sa tingin ninyo yung self-discipline na meron ka? Okay, assess muna natin ang ating sarili. And at the same time, ano kayang klaseng disiplina din meron ang members ng iyong pamilya? So it can be your parents and your anybody na member ng kapamilya mo. So kung ilan kayo sa inyong pamilya or ilan yung kasama mo sa bahay mo nung ikaw ay lumalaki, maaari mong ilagay sa table. Like for example, if you're living with your grandparents, if you're living with your auntie, with your relatives, so anybody na sa tingin mo ay influential sa pag naging influence or naka-influence sa paglaki mo, pwede mong ilagay dyan as member of your family. Then, you're going to write first the name of that family member following the table below on a piece of paper. So, feel free to add or remove rows based on the number of your family members. Kaya kung marami kayo, marami din ang ilalagay mong members of the family. Then, you're going to provide the reason why you rated them such. So, from 1 to 5, like for example, your mother, you feel that or you assess that your mother is very very disciplined. So therefore, ang score niya is 5. So now you're going to cite the reason why 5 ang ibinigay mong score sa iyong mother or sa iyong mama. Okay. Ano ba yung mga nakikita mong characteristics niya or na masasabi mo na siya ay self-disciplined na tao. Okay? So I hope that's clear. So, we can now proceed with the processing questions. If you'll notice, lahat ng activity meron processing questions. So, you're going to put your answer on a sheet of paper. Number one, you are going to answer this. What do you notice with your answers? So, ano ba yung napansin mo? So, pwedeng ang napansin mo ay lahat ng family members mo ay disciplined like you or lahat ng family members mo medyo mababa ang inilagay mong rating ng kanilang self-discipline. Ayan, makikita natin dyan yung pagkakahalintulad ng disiplina na meron ka sa disiplina na meron sa pamilya mo. Okay, yun ang pwede mong mga mailagay na notice or mailagay na observation sa sagot mo sa processing question number 1. And number 2, what were your considerations in writing your answers? Ano ba yung mga i-consider mo? So, possible na i-consider mo yung trabaho nila, possible na i-consider mo yung status nyo sa family, and yung laki ng family ninyo, whatsoever. Ano ba yung mga naging consideration mo sa paglagay mo sa sagot na yun? Like, for example, so, inilagay mo dyan na mataas ang self-discipline ng iyong mother because of the kind of job that she has or she had before, okay? Ano ba yung pwedeng yun ang naging isa sa mga consideration mo kaya nasabi mo na mataas ang level ng self-discipline ng iyong mother? Like, for example, if your mother is working as a government employee, as a teacher, kaya nalagay mo na mataas ang self-discipline niya dahil nakikita mo sa level ng kanyang sa ginagawa niya sa klase ng trabaho na meron siya. Okay. pwedeng ang consideration mo sa naging sagot mo is yung occupation nila. Still students, that's why medyo mababa pa yung, or they were still young, kaya medyo mababa ang kanilang self-discipline. And they're already mature enough, that's why mataas ang kanilang self-discipline. So yun ang mga pwedeng maging consideration mo sa paglagay sa sagot mo, okay? And number three, do you think you can still improve your self-discipline? Okay, yes or no? If yes, why? If no, why? Okay, then we are now going to proceed with this, okay? Keep in mind, so suggested time allotment is 30 minutes. Now we are going to discuss the different steps in order for you to develop self-discipline. Okay, napaka-importante ng disiplina sa sarili. Pero paano nga ba, di ba? Ang daling sabihin na disiplinahin ang sarili, pero paano? So let's try to have this. Sabi dito, when we say self-discipline, it is defined as an ability to take control of yourself, particularly your behavior, emotions, and impulses from committing thoughtless and irrational behavior. Again, ito daw yung kakayahan natin para makontrol ang ating mga sarili, particularly ang ating mga kilos, ang ating behavior, ang ating emosyon, ang ating mga impulses, para daw hindi tayo nakaka-commit ng mga thoughtless or hindi mga pinag-iisipang mga actions or behavior or irrational behavior. So it usually results in unpleasant and negative experiences. So it takes time to develop self-discipline, okay? And it requires certain level of awareness to fully understand how it works. So sabi nila, pag mas mature ka na, mas develop na ang iyong self-discipline. Kasi nga, I believe that this is a process, ano? Pinag-aaralan ito, at syempre, ito din ay bunga na din ng ating mga experiences sa buhay. So one important thing that you must learn is how to control your emotions. Do you know how to deal or to how to control your emotions? So we have how many types of emotions? Ano ba yung iba't ibang uri ng emotion? So ang emotion ay ito yung happiness, sadness, joy, anger. Okay, so those are only some examples of emotion. So, sabi dito, we have to know how to control or how to deal with the different situations in our family and even in your community. So, how are you going to react? How are you going to behave in case na mayroong isang event or isang pangyayari na dumating sa buhay natin? So, how do we react? So, it's a manifestation how disciplined you are as a person. If you can be able to control the emotion, the kind of emotions that you are going to have. Now, self-discipline could mean being on top of your emotions. It only means to say na pag ikaw daw ay self-disciplined, kung ikaw ay isang tao na mataas ang disiplina sa sarili, dapat alam mo kung paano kinokontrol ang emosyon mo. So, dapat daw, you are on the top of your emotion. Okay? And the best way to do is, to learn them first. Okay? Pag-aralan natin kung ano ba yung iba't ibang klase ng emosyon na meron tayo. At sa pamamagitan na din ng pagkilala sa ating sarili, ano ba yung mga ginagawa o madalas nating ginagawa once we have that particular emotion. Now, most of the time, emotions direct people's actions or behavior. So, isa to sa mga dahilan kung bakit natin ang emosyon ang dahilan kung bakit tayo nagbe-behave ng ganito, 'di ba? Emotions direct us to do something or to behave, 'di ba? For instance, sabi dito, isang example dito, if you are happy, you tend to smile, 'di ba? To do simple acts of celebration or even talk to your family or friends about it. So kung ano yung nararamdaman natin, yun din naman yung ginagawa natin or ipinapakita natin sa iba. When you are sad, you tend to isolate yourself from people, you don't have energy to continue your daily tasks or even keep yourself in silence, and humans react based on how we feel. So that's very important. So it is very important pala na sa emosyon pa lang natin, alam na natin kung paano ito i-manage. So yun ang magiging pinakasimula natin para madisiplina ang ating sarili. Because once we have this particular emotion, di ba? Sabi nga, ito yung nagiging dahilan kung bakit nakakagawa tayo ng isang bagay because of our emotion. So for example, galit na galit ka, your emotion is on that particular, your emotion on a particular moment is you are angry. Now, ano kaya sa tingin mo yung mga pwedeng mong gawin pag ikaw ay galit? So, if you know how to control your emotion, your anger, di ba? Ano yung mga pwede natin gawin para hindi tayo makagawa ng mga bagay na maaari nating pagsisihan pag tayo ay galit? So, yun ang mga dapat natin, di ba, matutunan. Like, for example, if you're angry, it's better to just go away, di ba? Or keep silent, or kumausap ka ng isang tao na pwedeng mapagsabihan mo ng iyong sama ng loob or ng galit mo para hindi ka na makapanakit ng iba, para hindi ka makapagsalita ng hindi maganda sa iba. Again, uulitin natin, pag alam mo kung paano i-control ang emosyon mo, it only means to say na mataas ang level ng iyong self-discipline or disiplina sa sarili. Okay. Sabi dito, humans react based on how we feel. And managing emotion is a good skill which forms part of self-discipline. So, yan pala. Managing emotion is a skill. So, again, pag sinabi natin skill, hindi naman ito basta-basta nakukuha. Ito ay pinag-aaralan din at kailangan din na i-practice para maging habit. Okay? So, here are some pointers to manage your emotions well. So, how are we going to manage our emotion? Number one, we have to recognize your emotion. Paano ba natin ma-recognize ang emotion natin? Okay? So, to recognize our emotion, we have to be mindful. Okay? Be mindful how you feel on a certain situation. For instance, whenever thoughts about schoolwork come to mind, how do you feel about it? Okay? Pag may mga naiisip kang gagawin sa school, ano ba yung nararamdaman mo? Do you feel sad? Do you feel nervous? Do you feel upset or ngarag? Ano ba yung nararamdaman mo? Okay? So, it is important for you to differentiate your thoughts from emotions. Okay? Thoughts are usual ideas while emotions are feelings. So, iba ang naiisip natin sa nararamdaman natin. Kailangan daw paghiwalayin natin yung mga naiisip natin sa nararamdaman natin. Because sometimes, di ba, nagdi-dictate ang emotion natin sa kung ano ang iisipin natin. So, therefore, we have to know that there are positive and negative emotions and both are normal part of your life. Okay? Parte yun. So, there's no such... nakalagay kasi dito, ano, know that there are positive and negative emotions. But for me, ano, but accordingly, there's no such thing as negative emotions. Siguro ang ibig sabihin ng dito sa module natin is negative emotion that can cause negative emotions that can cause negative behavior. Like for example, too much sadness, too much anger can cause negative behavior, okay? Because those emotions, all of our emotions are important. So like for example, hindi masama ang malungkot, hindi masama ang magalit, because those emotions are normal. Those are part of being us, being human. So therefore, kung nakakaramdam ka ng sobrang galit, for example, or sobrang lungkot, okay lang yun, di ba? It's how we deal out, it's how we manage our behaviors, how we manage our actions. So nagiging negative ang isang, masasabi natin magiging negative ang isang action pag hindi natin na manage na maayos ang ating emotion. Okay? So again, that is normal. So kailangan lang ma-recognize natin na at this moment I am feeling sad, I'm feeling upset. I'm feeling so angry, so what am I gonna do? Okay, ano bang gagawin ko para hindi naman ako makagawa ng hindi naaayon sa dapat kong gawin bilang isang estudyante, bilang isang anak, bilang isang tao. Okay, I hope that part is clear already. So we can now proceed with the next one. Okay, the next way or the next pointer that we have here in order for us to manage our emotions well is the next thing to do is to name your emotion. Sabi dito, the first part is na-recognize na natin ang emotion natin, di ba? So the next thing to do is to name your emotion. Ano ba? Ano ba yung emotion na yon? Okay? So whenever there is a situation at home or even in a community, can you name your feelings? With the current crisis, like for example, in this pandemic, we have COVID-19. Ano ba yung emosyon na pinaka nagsasurface ngayon na may pandemic tayo? So, malamang karamihan sa atin ay nalulungkot because we cannot do the normal things that we have nung wala pa tayong pandemic, right? So, malamang sa inyo, nalulungkot, nabuport. So, name that feeling. So, mahalaga na alam natin kung ano yung pakiramdam natin sa isang sitwasyon. Okay? With the current crisis, what do you feel? With the distance learning with the modality, tingnan ninyo na meron tayong online, na meron tayong mga module. Ano ba yung nararamdaman ninyo? What feelings best describe you now? And you may say, I feel happy, sad, angry, excited, scared, anxious, etc. Okay, ano ba yung emotion na nararamdaman mo sa mga nangyayari sa atin ngayon? Okay. So, kasi importante na klarado or clear. Kasi sometimes sasabihin na, I really don't know what I feel. Diba sabi natin, okay lang naman yun. But at this particular moment, but eventually, we'll realize, ay kailangan pala na alam ko din kung ano yung, dapat may label kung ano yung pakiramdam na yun para malinaw din sa'yo kung ano yung mga pwede mong gawin out of that feeling. Okay. So kung nararamdaman mo is you are very sad, you are sad. Now ano ba yung mga pwede nating gawin para at least, 'di ba, ma-ease yung sadness na yon. If you feel like you are always scared, now ano ba yung mga pwede nating gawin kasi ano ba yung mga pwede nating gawin para hindi ka laging natatakot. Okay. So again, number 2 and pointer that we have here is name your emotion. Okay. So after recognizing, so number 1 is recognizing your emotion, naming your emotion. Then the 3rd one is describe the intensity of your emotion. Gaano ba ka-intense ang emotion na meron tayo? Di ba? Na-identify na natin, napangalanan na natin kung anong emotion na yun. So ngayon naman, alamin naman natin kung gaano yung intensity nito. Gaano ito nakaka-apekto sa atin, di ba? It is important to know how your emotions looks like or sounds like. Okay. Some say that we are not supposed to make decisions at the height of our emotions. So for instance, when you are too happy and somebody asks you to a favor, you tend to say yes easily without thinking of the consequences. So napaka-importante ng pointer na to, ano? Alam dapat natin yung intensity ng emotion natin kasi too much is not good, okay? Ang sobrang happiness ay masama. Sabi dito sa example, ay masama pala na laging na grabe yung happiness. Yes, because there's a tendency when we are too happy, we decide things na kahit na hindi mo naman gusto na yun ang maging decision mo, you have this tendency to say yes easily na hindi natin pinag-iisipan yung consequences ng actions natin or ng decision natin. Therefore, lahat dapat ay in moderation. Everything, all of our emotions should be in moderation, 'di ba? Hindi maganda na sobra-sobra tayong natutuwa. Hindi din maganda na sobra-sobra ang ating pagkalungkot. Hindi maganda na sobra-sobra tayong natatakot. Ang sobra ay masama at ang kulang naman ay masama. Therefore, dapat lahat ay sakto lang or in moderation. So, alin nasaan ka ba dun? Diba? I-identify mo. Lagyan mo din ng i-describe mo kung ano ba yung intensity ng emotion na meron ka. Sobra-sobra bang natatakot ka ngayon? Or sakto lang? Okay, kung sakto lang, okay lang yun. Grabe ba ang sadness na nararamdaman mo ngayon? Ano ba yung intensity? So, pwede kang maglagay o magbigay ng scale from scale of 1 to 5. ang nasa ang intensity ka ba doon? Okay? So, from 0 to 5, siguro 3 as sakto lang, 0 as too little, and 5 as too much. Okay? Try to label or describe the intensity of emotion that you are having as of the moment. And for number 4, okay, so matapos nating i-describe ang intensity, we are now going to understand what emotion is telling you as it gives you clues or messages. Okay, intindihin naman natin ngayon kung ano yung mga emosyon na nagbibigay sa atin ng clue or nagsasabi sa atin ng clue or ng mensahe. Okay, ano bang ibig sabihin natin dito? Ano bang mensahe ang daladala ng emosyon na meron ka ngayon? Okay. So, kung ang emosyon mo ngayon ay you feel very scared, okay, because of COVID-19, ano ba yung mensahe na meron sa emosyon na yon? So, sabi dito, appreciate how and why you felt it and if it needs certain actions. So, for instance, if you feel angry, do you need to act on it? Or you can just feel and let it go after. So, lahat ng nararamdaman nating emosyon, sabi ko nga, ay may kahulugan. We just have to understand the message of that particular emotion. Why we are having this particular emotion? Why we are feeling this way or that way, di ba? So, instead of battling too much with our emotion, we have to appreciate. Sabi ko nga, di ba, lahat ng emosyon ay may dahilan or may reasons. Kaya hindi natin, pardon me if I have to go against with the so-called negative emotion, kasi para sa akin, ano, there's no such thing as negative emotion. Malamang nailagay ang negative emotion dyan dahil ibig sabihin, once we have this too much emotion, now, nagkakaroon tayo ng negative behavior or negative action out of that intense or too much emotion. Okay? So, again, sabi dito, kailangan natin intindihin yung message ng emosyon na meron tayo. Kasi yun ang magiging reason din para, in order for us to act on it or makagawa tayo ng paraan para hindi maging sobra-sobra or maging negative yung mga magawa natin sa bagay, na isa-isang bagay, dahil nga sa too much emotion na binibigay natin sa isang bagay. Okay. So, for example, sabi nga dyan, if you feel na nagagalit ka, now, ano yung message doon? Paano mo, anong gagawin mo if you are angry, di ba? Or if you are very mad, anong gagawin mo? If you're very sad, ano ang gagawin mo? So, dapat alam mo din kung ano yung mga possible ways on how to deal with a particular emotion. And number 5, take time to be with your emotion, okay? And try not to make it cloud your ideas, okay? Sabi dito, we have to take time thinking about that particular emotion. It doesn't necessarily mean na lungkot ka, hindi na maganda yun. I have to be happy. For example, your pet died. So, definitely, ano ba yung emotion na mararamdaman natin pag yung paborito nating alaga ay namatay? Definitely. Ang mararamdaman natin ay malulungkot tayo, di ba? So, of course, we have to recognize our feelings and emotions. So, definitely, the thing that will, the emotion that we will feel in that particular situation is we will be sad, okay? So, therefore, we have to take time to be with our emotions and try not to make it cloud your ideas. So it only means to say na we still have decide. We also have to decide wisely and do not make a decision out of anger, out of your emotion. Okay, so that's the 5th way on how we are going to manage our emotion. Now, for the next part, you can do it. Suggested time allotment is 30 minutes. So, as you can see, we still have here As you can see, we have another table here. What you're going to do is you're just going to choose a family or household member and try to compare your responses on the following situations. Okay? Pipili ka lang ng isa sa kasama mo sa bahay. Okay? At itatry natin i-compare yung mga responses. We are going to compare your response to the response of your chosen household member. So, write your answers on a clean piece of paper following the template below. So, the template is this one. So, ilitan ko ang aking picture para makita nyo ang table. Okay. So, the table has 3 columns. So, we have the first column, we consider the situation, and then you're going to write the response in the 2 other columns. Number 1, say example for the situation number 1, the number of COVID-19 cases is increasing in your barangay. So, isusulat natin ngayon kung ano yung response mo, what will be your response, or it can be a reaction, okay? And what you are going to ask a household member or a family member to for his or her response also to this particular situation. Okay. So tumataas ang COVID-19 cases sa inyong barangay. Ano kaya ang magiging response mo? At ano naman ang magiging response ng napili mong household member? For the number 2 situation, the situation is your family member broke something that is of great value to you without any apology. Hindi man lang siya nag-sorry or nag-apologize nang makabasag siya ng isang mahalagang bagay sa bahay ninyo. Okay, so what will be your response or what will be your reaction to that, and what will be the reaction or of your household member? So, mas maganda yata if you're going to answer this, you give your family member this particular situation para mas maging unique yung answer ninyo at hindi nyo agad mako-compare muna. Later nyo na mako-compare yung sagot ninyo, so sabay nyong sasagutan without you telling first that particular person kung ano din naman yung sagot mo. Okay? And for number 3, the situation is you are being tagged as a liar in your family. Okay, sinungaling ka daw. Kunwari, isa sa mga family member mo ang sinabihan ka ng sinungaling, or pag sinabing tagged, yun na yung tingin sa iyo ng iyong kapamilya or ng iyong iyong kapamilya. So, what will be your response to this? And we shall also know what will be the response of your chosen family member. Okay? And for the number 4 situation, your friend revealed your secret that he or she sworn to keep between the two of you. Ayan. Hindi na itago ng friend mo ang sikreto na dapat ay between lang sa inyong dalawa. Ano kaya ang magiging response mo dito? Siguro linawin natin, ano? So when we say response, what will be your action? So instead na, what will be your reaction? So iba yung, syempre pwede nating ilagay kung ano yung mararamdaman mo. Of course, for example, dito sa situation number 4 na ipinagsabi ng kaibigan mo yung sikreto, of course, ano yung mapifeel mo, and at the same time, what will you do? So yun ang ibig sabihin ng response natin dito. What will be your action? What will you do in case your friend revealed your secret that he or she sworn to keep between the two of you? O nangako ang friend mo na hindi niya ipagsasabi ang sikretong sinabi mo, yet sinabi niya sa iba. So what will you do? And number 5, you failed an important test in school. Bumagsak ka. So ano ngayon ang magiging response mo dito? So here in this activity, we are not just going to write our reaction, but also we are going to write our response. It means to say that we are going to write the possible things that you may do or you might do once this particular situation happens to you. Okay? So is that clear? Now, we are going to proceed with the next part. what I have learned. Okay, suggested time allotment is 30 minutes. So, based on your answers in the previous part of the module, try to analyze how you responded on the different situations. Can you say that you were in control of your emotions? Would your responses be the same if you were only 12 years old? Write your answers on a piece of paper in essay form with at least 3 or 4 paragraphs. Okay. So again, dito naman sa what I have learned, I'm going to read our answers on the previous part of the module at i-analyze natin kung paano ka ba talaga nagre-respond sa iba't ibang sitwasyon na sa iba't ibang sitwasyon, okay? So can you say na masasabi mo ba na ikaw talaga ay in control of your emotion? Nakokontrol mo ba kaya sa tingin mo ang emotion mo? And ang response mo ba sa tingin mo ay kahalintulad ng response mo nung ikaw ay, would your response be the same if you're only 12 years old? So we are going to write your answers on a piece of paper. Now for the next part, share your thoughts and feelings for 30 minutes. The title is We Are All Unique. So we will be needing again a piece of paper, and there you are going to choose a situation at home where your family members are doing their respective tasks and are showing self-discipline. Okay? Pipili tayo ng isang sitwasyon sa bahay kung saan yung mga kapamilya natin, mga family members natin, ay ginagawa ang kanilang mga task, okay? Or yung mga, it can be a responsibility, a job, okay? And are showing self-discipline, okay? Try to relate how it helps to build a good relationship with them. Okay. Paano kaya sa tingin mo ito nakakatulong para makabuo kayo ng magandang relasyon sa isa't isa? Okay. So, it's done. So, ayan, we are done with Module 2, my dear grade 8 students. So, thank you so much again for watching this video. So, I hope na may natutunan tayo para sa araw na ito. Again, the title of our activity is The Better Me. So, it only means to say na talagang maaari tayong maging better every day, especially if we are self-disciplined, if we know how to deal our emotion, how to manage our emotion, and know how to respond to it, okay? As I've said, again, uulitin ko, it's okay not to be okay. It's okay to feel these emotions, like for example, sadness, anger, so walang problema doon. As long as you can manage it, you know how to control it, you know how to respond to it, little by little, ano, mas madi-develop natin ang self-discipline natin because we know how to take care of ourselves by means of properly expressing our emotions, properly dealing with our feelings. How are we going to manage all the difficulties that we have in our lives, diba? So isa ito sa mga napaka-importante na kailangan talaga nating ma-develop aside from our emotions, diba? We have to be resilient. Ibig sabihin, kailangan na alam natin kung paano natin malalampasan ang lahat ng pagsubok na madadaanan natin sa ating buhay. And definitely, isa sa mga talagang kailangan natin magiging sandata natin ang pagkakaroon ng well-developed self-discipline and good mental hygiene. Little by little, we'll just mama-master na lang natin yan. I hope that you were able to accomplish your module 2, my grade 8 students. So, that will be all for now. So, again, thank you so much. And again, this is Ma'am Terebena, your guidance counselor, saying bye for now and see you on module 3.